الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Your brother Abu Dhar from the Ruqya Services. Welcome again to another video. Today, inshallah ta'ala, I discuss with you a very important matter, a question that has been raised many times. Can jinn tell the future? Do jinn know what's going to happen in ilm al-ghayb? Can jinn predict what's going to happen in your life or my life? If no, how come some people, they say, we use the jinn, and actually they can tell you about some stuff that happened in your personal life? Again, our video today will be based upon Quran and Sunnah, and will be based upon proof from the Sharia, from the Quranic point of view. So we don't speak from the culture, and we don't speak from the myth point of view. When we say Ilmul Ghayb, the unseen word, we say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Alimul Ghayb wa Shahada, it's Him, Azza wa Jal, who have the unseen of everything that belongs to Ilmul Ghayb. In fact, even the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala don't know the unseen. So our proof from the Sharia point of view that jinn do not know the unseen and cannot predict what's going to happen in the future is from Surah Saba, verse number 12, 13.
Well, now, a quick note, in the recording, I said the name of the Surah Saba, which it's named in English. But however, the name of the Surah in Arabic is Surah Saba', Surah number 34. In case somebody think that the Sheikh don't know the name of the Surah, Jazakum Allah.
Surah Saba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that He, peace be upon Him, Allah Azza wa Jal gave Sulaiman, peace be upon him, alayhi salam, a power over the wind and over the jinn. Sulaiman alayhi salam, we know he's a prophet and a king, and Allah gave him the power over the jinn and the shayateen. They work for him. So in Surah Saba, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, and we gave to Sulaiman, again we are speaking about verse 12, 13, 14, Allah say, we gave to Sulaiman the jinn and the shayateen, they work for him. And any one of them who disobey Sulaiman alayhi salam, Allah said, they will punish them and Sulaiman will be able to command them. Now, the proof that the jinn do not know the unseen. Allah say in Surah Saba, verse 14, and when Allah decided that the soul of Sulaiman alayhi salam will depart to Allah, meaning the moment of death of Sulaiman alayhi salam, the jinn, they did not know that Sulaiman alayhi salam has died only with the effect of the body of Sulaiman alayhi salam fall on the floor. The tafsir of this verse is the following. Sulaiman alayhi salam, when he passed away, when his soul went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he was leaning in one shoulder in a wall, and his right hand, he had a wooden stick. And this is from tafsir Ibn al-Kathir. He had a wooden stick that he's leaning upon. And the jinn, they were working for him. However, when Allah decided that the soul of Sulaiman alayhi salam will depart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the body of Sulaiman stayed like this for a certain period of time, meaning in one position, like this. And till Allah Azza wa Jal, He has sent a little insect. Allah say in the Quran, Dabba. We don't know. It's a creation of Allah. An insect or a creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that started eating from the stick of Sulaiman alayhi salam. And when she started eating from the stick, then the stick fell, then the body fell. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran that when the jinn, they looked around and they found out that the body of Sulaiman alayhi salam fell in the floor and he's dead, Allah said in the Quran, there the jinn, they realized they don't know the unseen. And if they knew the unseen, they would have guessed that Sulaiman alayhi salam, who's watching them, he's actually passed away, dead, and they were not stayed working in the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So again, our proof is, if the jinn know the unseen or can tell the unseen, how come they were punished working for Sulaiman alayhi salam when Sulaiman alayhi salam, he passed away, and the jinn did not know this. So therefore the jinn realized they don't know the unseen world. Another proof that the jinn do not know the unseen world and cannot predict the future. Allah says in Surah Al-Jinn, after أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, وَأَنَّا لَنَدْرِي أَشَرٌ أُرِيدَ بِمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ أَمْ أَرَادَ بِهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ رَشَدًا. Allah says that the jinn says, and we cannot predict, we do not know if Allah has decided good about the people of the planet humans or decided to punish them. This is another proof that the jinn do not know the future. Somebody will ask a question and say, so how come I went to see a maulana or a practitioner and he actually asked for my mother's name and he looked at me in the eyes and he guessed how many children do I have, what is my job, what happened to me in the past, and he can say about some incident happened on my life. Everybody or most of us know the answer to this question. It's because every one of us have three creation that lives with him from the day he's born till the day he dies, which is the angel of the right, the angel of the left, this one here write your good deeds, this one write your bad deeds, and the qareen is this shaitan from the jinn who is born with you, he's attached to you, and his job is to misguide you, wal'audhu billah, and lead you to the hellfire. If the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had a qareen, yes, if the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had a qareen, and he alayhi salatu wasalam say that Allah made his qareen a Muslim in order to make the da'wah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam easy. Now, therefore, this person you have seen, he actually asks help of the jinn. He's communicating with his own jinns. So when he looks at you and he asks for your mother's name, he's communicating with his jinns, and his jinns, they're gonna come to your qareen and investigate with your qareen some information about yourself. It's normal because your qareen, he's with you all the time. He knows what you had for breakfast. He know your name of your children. He know how many cars you had. He know what is your job. He know many important information, personal information about you. In fact, this man who's using the jinn to tell you about yourself, pretending that he can help you and he's got power from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all what he's doing, he's investigating from his jinns to your qareen, whom given to the jinn of the practitioner some information about you. So therefore, it's a trick. They tell you lots about yourself and you feel amazed, and then you are amazed, you realize that they have power, or you believe they have power, therefore you trust them, therefore they hurt you, and the scam is pretty there. But however, somebody will ask the question and say, how come so there is some humans, they say we can predict the future, and actually they are correct and they tell you some real stuff about the future. However, the explanation of this one is in the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam mentioned that some shayateen, they used to travel very far to the first heaven, and they used to pay attention to what the angels of Allah are saying, and they used to steal one word from what the angel are saying, and they will bring it back to wal'audhu billah, the magicians of this planet, and they will tell them certain information. Then the human being of the magician, he will mix this one information with any many hundreds of other information in order to misguide you. And Allah say in Surah Al-Jinn, this verses, Allah say after A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitanir Rajeem, Allah say, وَأَنَّا كُنَّا نَقْعُدُ مِنْهَا مَقَاعِدَ لِلسَّمْعِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say to us, the jinn says, we used to sit down in a certain position close to the heavens. نَسْتَيْقُ السَّمْعِ, we are trying to listen what's happened. Allah says, فَمَنْ يَسْتَمِعَ الْآنَ يَجَدْ لَهُ شِهَابًا رَصَدًا. From now on, whoever is listening from the jinn to what the angels are saying, Allah will send a flying star, a shooting star that will harm them, so therefore they cannot steal the information. Somebody will ask this question right now, but you said the angels of Allah don't know the unseen, don't know what's going to happen in the planet, cannot predict what's happening in the planet. So how come some of the shayateen sit down close to the first heaven and they can hear what the angels are saying? The tafsir of the hadith of this verse actually saying, Allah Azza wa Jal subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he decide the matter and he write a matter, Allah Azza wa Jal, when he decides something is going to happen, he called Jibreel alayhi salam and he say, oh Jibreel, this and this and this is going to happen, and all the angels of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are going to bow to the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala azza wa jal to his orders. Subhanallah, Allahu Akbar, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, Subhanallah. And then the heavens, they're going to shake from the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the angels of the seven heavens, six heavens, fifth heavens, four heavens, third, two, one, they're going to tell each other what Allah has decided for the matter to be and is going to be. So therefore, they don't know by themselves the angel what's going to happen. It's Allah Azza wa Jal decision, but the shayateen and the jinn, they will try to play the trick to steal some information. So we have proved here from Surah Al-Saba, the story how Sulaiman alayhi salam died, how Sulaiman alayhi salam's soul departed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and how the jinn could not even tell that Sulaiman alayhi salam was dead, and they stayed working for a certain number of years or months or days, Allah knows better, for Sulaiman alayhi salam when Sulaiman alayhi salam was dead. So indeed the jinn and the shayateen cannot tell the future, cannot predict the future, and it's very important for us as Muslims to know only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the ghaib. So therefore, if you go to any practitioner who asks you for your mother's name, or who asks you for your cloth, who asks you for anything that does not make sense, or you see them moving the lips in a very weird movement, bear in mind they're gonna work with jinn, and indeed the jinn cannot tell the future, they cannot predict anything, and they don't know the unseen. And this is a very powerful message to my brothers and my sisters. Be careful, don't get scammed, believe only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and there's no such a thing, jinn can tell you about the future. So to conclude the video, my brothers and sisters, if any time you are doing ruqya of a family member, or you practice ruqya and you are new to the field of the ruqya sharia, and yet you have a jinn who start telling you nonsense about the future or about ilmul ghaib, please be careful, do not trust, do not believe, because only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the future, and all the knowledge of ilmul ghaib is in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hands. So therefore we need to understand something. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to us, كَذَبَ الْمُنَجِّمُونَ وَلَوْ صَدَقُوا. Indeed, the fortune tellers, they are not telling the truth and they are liars. Even some of them information meets some reality and it does not adopt your head. How come they know some personal information about me? How come they can predict some of the future? And any person in the Sharia of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in our religion, any person who believe a fortune teller, indeed his salat is not going to be accepted for 40 days. So we have to be careful. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make everyone in a safe side. May Allah Azza wa Jal give you the best of the iman. Inshallah we keep safe. Inshallah we do not fear so much the word of the jinn, and we shouldn't think about it so much that it is so important. Do not think about it. Do not try to communicate with jinn. Do not try to fear them. Indeed, they are just creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have been created just to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, please, down below in the comments, if there is any topic you wanted me to speak about, or you want any other subject about any other video you want me to do, please give me some suggestions, give me some ideas, and I'm happy to share with you whatever we know, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows better. Soon, inshallah ta'ala, I will be making as well my personal story with ruqya cases and my personal story with jinn activities as a raqi, what I've seen, what worst cases, and how does this creation of Allah play when I perform the ruqya? Jazakum Allah khairan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it easy for you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, brother Abu Dhar, the Ruqya Services.